waking up Eastern Carolina and the world. You're listening to the number one morning show in Pitt County with North Carolina Broadcasters Hall of Fame host, Henry Hinton. Listen on air or online at WTIBFM.com. This is Talk of the Town.
Five minutes after eight, welcome in. Hour two of Talk of the Town for Wednesday morning, April 25th. Henry and McGee and Weaver here in the studio. We got Coach Carr and Michael and Daniel, our intern, in the control room. So we could have a three-on-three basketball game, and I could post Coach up and slam on him.
Let's do it.
Yeah. How you guys doing? Everything good?
Make it rain.
Make it rain. We're in the studio today and tomorrow, and then Friday morning live on location at 400 St. Andrews for our candidates forum for Pitt County Sheriff and Pitt County District Attorney. And then a week from Friday, on location again in the Greenville Convention Center, it's going to be the Greenville Chamber of Commerce Business Expo. McGee, it's going to be huge. Going to be huge.
Huge. Let me
tell you,
huge.
Like 100 business exhibits.
Close to 130.
130. Wow. You guys do well with that. And then we will, as part of that, we will be having, as I think this is the fourth year we've done the summit at
the
Expo.
Fourth annual.
We will have a discussion of all things involving our community. It's the Greenville Community Summit that will be in the Convention Center as part of the Chamber Expo. We'll be there live doing that. It will be broadcasting live all morning, and we'll have community leaders from all over the different walks of life. And talking about things like traffic. I'm excited about Bill Kincannon is from the North Carolina Department of Transportation is going to be there that morning. He's going to give us an update on when the 10th Street Connector is going to open, or as we now know it, Leo Jenkins Boulevard. I guess that's official now, isn't it? Everybody's voted that that's going to be the
Leo Jenkins Boulevard name. Yeah.
Yeah. Leo Jenkins Boulevard. When Jenkins Boulevard will open, when the Southwest Bypass four-lane superhighway around the southwest loop of Greenville, around behind Pitt Community College and empty out on Highway 11 on number out there around 903. When you go out past 903 and Aiden and you're going out toward the Pepsi plant, you can see they built the huge mountain where it's going to come down. So a lot of great road. What else? What are the other big road construction? The other big one is the widening of the Evans Street extension, which is going to be widened all the way from Greenville Boulevard
that
out
hasn't
to
even started
Fire
yet,
Tower.
Though.
No, out to Fire Tower Road. So we'll have a full report on that. We'll also have a session on crime and public safety in Greenville. We're going to look at Greenville's economy. Going to talk about healthcare, a lot of those things, the Greenville Community Summit. And as always, we'll have a live mic in the audience for people to participate and ask our panelists questions. We'll be telling you more about the panelists as we get closer. But the Greenville Community Summit will take place on Friday morning, May the 4th, inside the Convention Center, brought to you this year by a great group of sponsors, including Michael Overton at the Overton Group. Michael, thank you for stepping up and sponsoring the summit this year. Also, Greenville Utilities, John Gavigan, Nationwide Insurance Agency. You know, John has now taken over the Ramey Steins agency here. Ramey's going to retire, working with Ramey. And John, of course, grew up with my son, a Nationwide agent down in New Bern for many years, and now he's going to be in New Bern and Greenville. He's global, that Gavigan boy is.
Huge.
Huge.
And also Pizza Inn locations in Greenville and Washington will sponsor the Greenville Community Summit on May 4th. So the Candidates Forum at 400 St. Andrews this Friday, the Community Summit coming up a week from Friday inside the Convention Center. And then on Thursday, May the 9th, our first concert on the Common. Man, we're so busy these days. We've got so much going on. Our concert on the Common, it's an idea whose time has come for Greenville, an after work party with adult beverages being sold on the town common, first time ever in Greenville. And our sister station, 107.9, is bringing in the Embers, Craig Willard and the Embers, starting about 5:30 on Thursday afternoon, May 9th. Be there or be square. It's going to be fun. We'll be talking more about that as well. And thanks to our concert on the common sponsors, Greenville Toyota, Keller Williams Points East, Vidant Health, Bojangles, and our friend Polly Pyland at State Farm Insurance.
Okay, how's the alcohol going to work? Are they going to have a beer garden? Are you going to be able to see the stage? How does that work?
The new town, or I'm glad you asked that. The new city ordinance allows you to buy beer on the this never been done before. This ordinance only passed a couple of weeks ago. That's why we're doing this we've never been able to do this before. We're going to have beer stations, beer and wine stations on the mall, on the town common. You'll be able to buy beer. You'll be able to go right down to the stage with it.
Yeah, but there's got to be some kind of parameters where you can't
You got to stay on the town common.
Right.
Can't
right.
get in your car.
Not going to be able to allowed to leave, just like you couldn't leave a bar with.
Right.
One,
right.
Know?
And that's why I was wondering.
And there will be plenty of public safety people on hand to make sure that you don't make that mistake.
Yeah.
That's coming up May 9th.
Well, that's pretty neat because a lot of times with those events, you have a beer garden and you're confined to a small space and it's crowded and you're nowhere near the stage where you can actually enjoy the band.
Not going to be that case.
Pretty good.
Yeah. Thanks to our city council who's being forward thinking on that and giving us an opportunity to make this work, which we're really excited about. All right, last hour we talked about the fact that the jury has the Cosby case. Did you guys watch Cosby when it was on back
in the 80s?
You did?
I did.
Was it one of your favorite shows?
No.
There's a new survey out about what millennials, and would you guys be considered a millennial?
No, I'm Gen X.
Are you?
Remind me again.
Millennials, okay, here it is. Millennials would be 18 to 24 years old. So we only have one millennial in this room right now, in the control room, which is Daniel, our intern. Daniel, how old are you?
24.
So you're barely a millennial.
I think millennials should go up to about 27 or 8.
We have the top 10 TV shows. Favorite TV shows all time for millennials. What is your favorite TV show of all time, Daniel?
Breaking Bad.
That's a good one.
It's a good one.
Dude, you're right in there with me.
But wait, is that a show? What's
a series?
It's a series. Yeah. Isn't there a difference?
Maybe.
I mean.
All right, take another shot.
Do you have another Cosby show?
Do you have another one that's not like a series? But I agree with you, by the way. I'd have to put
But if you're a millennial, Netflix series is your show.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Good point.
You know, that's
Do you have
that's
another one, though,
millennial
Daniel?
Thing.
What would be your second favorite?
Big sitcom fan, so probably Seinfeld.
Man, that's pretty interesting for a guy your age.
Pretty good ones.
Seinfeld wasn't even on when you were born, was it? All right, I know what my favorite TV. I'm not a millennial. My favorite TV show of all time, it's very easy for me, would be The Andy Griffith Show. I still watch it. I watched it last night on MeTV. I watch Andy Griffith incessantly. It has to be my favorite. But I got to tell you that Breaking Bad would probably be number two for me. How about you, Wee? What's your favorite?
I did like Breaking Bad. There's so many good ones, but one of the TV shows, my all time favorite, and this might surprise you a little bit, is still on. The Big Bang Theory.
Really?
Yeah, funny.
Mm-hmm. No kidding.
Yeah.
That didn't make the top 10 for the millennials.
I didn't think it would, but.
McGee, what about you? Favorite TV show of all time?
I had two I had to always watch. WKRP in Cincinnati.
Oh, yeah.
Loved watching it.
That's a great show.
And you're going to laugh at this one, but I loved watching Full House when I was a kid.
Oh,
that was a favorite TV show of mine.
Full House.
I used to like the Brady Bunch. I used to love
I
like
the Brady Bunch.
Coming home from school and watching the Brady Bunch.
Coach Carr, favorite TV show of all time? Are you serious? The Love Boat? Oh my God!
Nothing wrong with the Love Boat.
Oh yes, it is. That was the worst acting ever.
I used to like Fantasy Island right after Love Boat. That was awesome too.
Love Boat was the TV show where all the aging former stars would go just to get a cameo, you know.
Yeah.
And then you had
Love Boat.
That's funny. Michael, favorite TV show of all time?
Star Trek.
Oh, why does that not surprise me?
And if you love Star Trek, there's a great fan
series called, why did I even ask?
There's a great fan series called Star Trek Continues.
Michael, we don't care.
They duplicate Star Trek.
Michael,
it's great.
This is not Nerds on Radio.
It's not Nerds on Radio.
Stop.
I'll tell you what the number one all-time favorite show is. You ready? Look at your list. I Love Lucy.
Not on here.
Really?
These are millennials.
Oh, these are millennials. 18 to 24 years.
Okay, here's the list. Number 10, Family Guy.
All
right. Confirm these or deny these for me, millennial. Daniel the Intern. Family Guy. Yes or no?
I'm not a big fan.
House, number 9.
I've seen a little bit of it.
Saturday Night Live.
It's not as good as it used to be.
Correct.
There you go. Correct.
I think Daniel's an old soul.
He is an old soul.
Number 7, The Price is Right. Are you serious?
Come on down. You're the next contestant.
That's because the millennials are watching that Price is Right in between classes.
I did like that.
Have you ever watched The Price is Right, Daniel? Tell the truth.
I used to watch it with my grandma when I was little.
Yeah. So you saw the Bob Barker version, which is the one we grew up with, not the Drew Carey one. Number 6, Wheel of Fortune. Wheel of Fortune.
I still watch it every night.
Do you really?
Yeah. Emery loves it.
I can't. Oh,
it's her show.
Your one-year-old daughter loves.
She loves
Wheel of Fortune.
The sound of the spinning wheel, and when Vanna White hits the letters, and it makes the noise, ding, ding.
By the way, how old is Vanna White now? She's got to be
in her 60s.
She's getting long in the tooth, isn't she? Time for a new model?
She hadn't changed at all.
She looks good.
What do you mean she hadn't changed at all?
She looks the same as she looked when she started in 1984.
Yeah,
I'm gonna say like
out of North Myrtle Beach.
I'm gonna tell you George. Who was the great actor who lived in Washington, was in The Graduate, when he said to Dustin Hoffman in The Graduate, one word, Benjamin, plastics.
There's nothing wrong with that.
I just got to tell you about Vanna White.
She's not the only one.
McGee, one word.
She's not the only one.
Plastics.
Nothing wrong with that. Don't hate.
All right, number 5 was Friends.
Yeah, Friends was good. I love Friends.
But, I mean, you're not a millennial.
Friends was good.
Do you like Friends, Daniel?
Yeah, I do. I've seen it all the way through at least a couple times.
All right, here's the top 4. These are really surprising. Number 4, America's Funniest Home Videos. Number 3 is Jeopardy. This is
watch
Jeopardy.
That, too.
Do you watch Jeopardy?
Watch a little bit, not much.
Number 2, The Simpsons.
Yeah.
And number 1 TV show, 73% of the vote, millennials love, The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Did watch that a lot.
Do it, McGee.
Doom, 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 doom. Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. Now I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there, tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air.
Yeah.
That's all I got right now.
No, come on. Finish it up. Let's go.
In West Philadelphia, born and raised on the playgrounds where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school when a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got one little fight. My mom got scared. She said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel-Air." I whistled for a all right, I'm going to stop there.
You got to finish it.
I whistled for a cab, and when it came near, the license plate said fresh. It had a dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say the discount was real, but I thought, nah, forget it. Your home's to Bel-Air.
Yes. All right, now here's the question. Now you know every word of that. Could you do the Lord's Prayer?
Wow, he went there.
No, I could.
He went there.
I could. Yes, I can. I can.
I'm not going to ask you to do
that. I can.
But that was awesome. I got to say that.
I can't do the Lord's
Prayer. Number one TV show for millennials.
I watched it too.
The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. That was a funny show. That was a funny show. All right, 19 minutes after 8 o'clock. Let's get a break in. More Talk of the Town on the way. We've got
my life got flipped.
There it is.
Upside down, and I'd like to take
come
a
on.
Minute. Just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air.
Everyone knows this.
Ladies and gentlemen, Trent McGee.
In West Philadelphia. Okay, I missed it.
This is the end
extended
of it.
Version.
It's the end.
This is the LP version, isn't it?
Wow.
In West Philadelphia, born and raised on the playground of where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school when a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel-Air." I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me away.
The crazy
she
thing about it is people driving to work who are also singing this.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, we'll be right back. First
first class.
Get to Greenville Toyota during the Spring Fling event and buy Corollas $14,999 or lease for just $99 a month. Camrys $18,995 or $129 a month at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't. So people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is the truck dealer in Eastern North Carolina. We are overloaded with new Ram trucks, and we've discounted every one of them to move.
It's the spring sales event. Folks from all over Eastern North Carolina are heading to Washington to save on new Ram trucks. Get up to $12,000 in total savings on select Ram 1500 trucks right now.
Visit us at WashingtonChrysler.com. Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Drive a little to save a lot.
The road to success is always under construction. It starts with a foundation established by the men that came before. It takes a first-class facility where pirates can assemble on Saturdays in the fall. And it takes all hands on deck to accomplish greatness through the purchase of ECU football season tickets and membership in the Pirate Club. 2018 is a new opportunity to build, and we're here to create. Join us by visiting ecupirates.com.
Get new Toyotas just $149 a month during the Spring Fling event at Greenville Toyota. Buy RAV4s from $21,995 or $149 a month. Plus, get our advantage. You can't miss the Spring Fling event at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
The OptiFast program at the Vidant Wellness Center is not your typical weight loss program. OptiFast is a safe, professionally supervised meal replacement program, combining comprehensive lifestyle changes along with expert counseling and ongoing personalized support.
At the end of the 12-week program, I was so happy because I met my goal. I lost the 25 pounds that was my target. I dropped 2 pant sizes. It was simple, shakes, bars, and foods. You do that and the weight starts to come off. The product, it tastes good, it fills you up. So I love that I joined. I love that I met my target. This program is a lifestyle change for me.
WNCT wants you to win a brand new 2018 Toyota Camry SE from Massey Toyota. Just listen to Mark, Mark, and Laura at 7:10 every morning for details on the birthday game. The game you were born to win from your friends at
WNCT
Hinton.
Baby. You know who that is? Craig Willard and the Embers. That's Craig Willard's bit song, What You Do to Me. What you do to me. I can't sing it like a McGee can sing the Fresh Prince song.
That's a good thing.
Embers will be on stage, the Greenville Toyota Amphitheater, 2 weeks from tomorrow. 2 weeks from tomorrow, May 9th. Our first sunset concert on the Common. And we'll be talking more about that. But tell your friends. Actually, it's 2 weeks from tonight. It's Wednesday, May 9th, not Thursday, May 9th. It's Wednesday night, May 9th. It'll be our first concert on the Common with Craig Woolard and the Embers. All right, 8:24. We're going to go to Weaver here with news headlines. Catch us up on that stabbing that took place in downtown Greenville last night in a second. But first, some good economic news has just been released through Carolina Journal. This just came out. North Carolina has been ranked 7th in the country for states for economic outlook, according to the 2018 edition of the American Legislative Exchange Council's Rich States, Poor States. The nonpartisan membership organization of state legislators has ranked states on economic outlook and performance for 11 years due to what they call a record of substantive pro-growth tax cuts. North Carolina has now made the top 10 list along with Utah, Idaho, Indiana, New York, Vermont, Illinois, California. Wait a minute. No. I'm sorry. The top 10 list with Utah, Idaho, and Indiana. Making the bottom 10 list, New York, Vermont, Illinois, and California. I was trying to figure out how did California end up in there. The rankings are out, and it looks like North Carolina's economic growth is going to continue. Won't it be nice if the legislators can figure out how to get some of that east of I-95 instead of all of it going from Raleigh to Charlotte again? Just a hint.
Would be nice.
For all of you running for office who want to do something for eastern North Carolina, there's an idea for you. 26 after 8, let's check our news headlines now from WITN. Billy Weaver's in the studio with us. Good morning, Weave.
Good morning, Henry. It is 8:26. It is 61 degrees in Greenville. I'm Billy Weaver, and this is a look at your WITN news headlines. Three people are injured after an early morning stabbing in the east, and police say they have someone in custody. Authorities say it happened in the parking lot outside of Sup Dogs in uptown Greenville. According to an ECU alert, two people were stabbed, and another was injured just before 1 a.m. this morning. Police say at least one of the victims was taken to Vidant Medical Center, but none of the victims' conditions are known at this time. Police did tell us that one person was taken into custody in connection with the stabbing. We do expect to learn the name of the person charged later this morning, so keep an eye on WITN and on WITN.com for more information. Well, today marks day two of the trial of one of two men accused of stabbing an autistic man to death outside of a local Walmart. Greenville resident Michael O'Neill faces life in prison if convicted of killing 22-year-old Stephen Rouse. On Tuesday, the jury heard opening statements and witness testimony describing a confrontation involving Rouse and O'Neill along with another man, Curtis Wade. A witness testified that O'Neill and Wade chased the victim from Park West Apartments towards Walmart and caught him in a field. The witness said she believes that the men thought Rouse had disrespected two female friends they had earlier on that day on a city bus. Rouse, whose family said he has Asperger's syndrome, was stabbed multiple times in a field off of Park West Drive back in October of 2015. Now, O'Neill's trial continues this week, while Curtis Wade's murder case will be handled separately. And a local daycare says it's suspending corporal punishment after a surprise inspection revealed it has never been approved. Shannon Jacobs, the director of Trinity Christian School Daycare, is facing assault charges for allegedly hitting a two-year-old twice with a paint stirrer, leaving bruises on the toddler that lasted for days. It was after that incident that the State Department of Health and Human Services conducted an unannounced inspection of the daycare center. A report released after the inspection indicated that in addition to the paint stirrer incident, there was also an alleged incident involving a staff member reportedly dragging a child by the arm across a classroom while another staff member held the child's legs. Other staff tried to take off the child's shirt as a form of discipline. Now, while the state says corporal punishment is allowed in religious-sponsored daycare facilities, Trinity did not submit the necessary paperwork that would approve it. A statement from the school says its staff has decided to immediately discontinue any corporal punishment at the school and rely on other disciplinary measures for their students. It is currently 8:29, 61 degrees in Greenville. I'm Billy Weaver, and that's a look at your WITN news headlines.
Thank you, Mr. Weaver. Let's check our weather update now. Here with that is the Fresh Prince of Woodland.
Yeah,
the Duke of Woodland.
That's right. The partly sunny skies for today with a few showers possible this afternoon. Rain chance 20 to 30% for tonight. Partly cloudy skies with a stray evening shower possible. Lows in the mid-50s. Thursday looking a little bit better. Partly sunny skies with a high of 74. No rain in sight. Lows tomorrow night would be in the upper 50s. And a slight chance of a shower early on Friday. Otherwise, partly sunny skies, 73 degrees for the high.
All right, news and weather service this morning of the Tire Realty Group and Property Management Team. You know, when you want to sell your home, most agents come out, slap a for sale sign in your yard, and that's pretty much it. Has that been your experience? Yeah. The agents at Tire Realty Group spend thousands of dollars every month to get exposure for your home if you list with them. Stuff like this radio ad, other things that they do. In fact, they put their paychecks on the line. If the agents at Tire Realty do not sell your Pitt County home in 99 days, they won't charge you a dime to sell it. They'll still sell it. They just won't take a commission. So that's what you call confidence in the ability to find the right buyer for your home. If you and your home qualify, you may accept the guarantee that Tire Realty Group will sell your present home at an agreed-upon price within 99 days, or there will be no charge to sell your home. That's a pretty good deal. Also, never an upfront fee. And, of course, you can also fire them at any time and pay them nothing. That's just the way it goes. So contact the Tire Realty Group at 758-HOME. That's 758-4663. You can visit them online at 99orfree.com. By the way, CNN.com this morning is promoting the fact that real estate prices posted an annual gain of 6.3% in February. On a national level, home sale prices are up 6.7% from the largest peak in the last 10 years in July of 2006. So home prices are good. They need inventory. Call the Homer Tire team today at 758-HOME. That's 758-4663. All right, 8:32, 28 minutes in front of 9 o'clock. More Talk of the Town on the way. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Let us help you find the right car or truck this spring here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come test drive the all-new redesigned 2018 Jeep Wrangler and take advantage of April lease specials on all-new Jeeps during the spring sales event. Lease a 2018 Wrangler JL for just $209 a month. Lease the new 2019 Jeep Cherokee for only $199 a month. Or lease a new Jeep Grand Cherokee for only $259 a month.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't. So people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
The OptiFast program at the Vidant Wellness Center is not your typical weight loss program. OptiFast is a safe, professionally supervised meal replacement program combining comprehensive lifestyle changes along with expert counseling and ongoing personalized support.
At the end of the 12-week program, I was so happy because I met my goal. I lost the 25 pounds that was my target. I dropped 2 pant sizes. It was simple, shakes, bars, and foods. You do that and the weight starts to come off. The product, it tastes good, it fills you up. So I love that I joined, I love that I met my target. This program is a lifestyle change for me.
To success is always under construction. It starts with a foundation established by the men that came before. It takes a first-class facility where pirates can assemble on Saturdays in the fall. And it takes all hands on deck to accomplish greatness through the purchase of ECU football season tickets and membership in the Pirate Club. 2018 is a new opportunity to build, and we're here to create. Join us by visiting ecupirates.com.
Let us help you find the right car or truck this spring here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
See ya. Gracias.
Get up to $12,000 in total savings on select Ram 1500 trucks during the spring sales event. That's up to $12,000 off a new Ram in April. You can't beat this deal on a new truck. Hurry in before they're all gone.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
107.9 WMCT wants you to win a brand new 2018 Toyota Camry SE from Massey Toyota. Just listen to Mark, Mark, and Laura at 7:10 every morning for details on the birthday game. The game you were born to win from your friends at
WMCT.
Listen up, everybody.
Talk of the town on 103.7 WTIV and 94.1 WNBU.
Now, here we go.
Now, here's Henry Hinton.
Talk of the town at 8:36. Welcome back. Coming up this weekend here in Greenville, an opportunity for you to get some really nice art from local artists. It's the annual Greenville Brushstrokes Group having their annual sale. And here to talk about that, my friend Blake Honeycutt, who I've not seen in a while. How you been?
Good.
Nice to see you. Are you an artist?
I am.
Are you really? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. John Grossner, one of my friends from church, usually comes on and does this interview. He's chairman again this year, but he was busy this
morning. Wanted me to come this year.
He did. Last year he did the painting of my face that looked like Harry Carey. That my wife put up in the kitchen for a while, then I made her take it down.
He's great.
He did a portrait of me with you. Yeah. You doing well?
I'm doing well. Thank you.
For people who don't know, tell us about the Greenville Brushstrokes Group. This is a really cool group of local artists who get together and support each other.
It is. It is. It is, Henry. We try to promote each other's work, which is what we're doing this weekend at the show. And we try to critique each other's work. And we give good information. We'll have workshops, we'll have demos, all kinds of things to increase your ability to paint well.
And then once a year you have this sale where you invite people to come in and buy what you paint.
That's right.
I'll tell you, people may not realize how good this stuff is. I mean, we have some really, really talented people here.
We have amazing artists in the Greenville area. Yeah. We really, really do. We really have it twice a year. We have a Christmas show and then we have a spring show.
Okay.
So this is our spring show. And drum roll, if you want to show the painting.
Yeah, now, for people on radio, you can't see this, but I'm going to show a painting here.
It's upside down.
Oh, it's upside down? I knew that. Okay, I couldn't see the monitor. There we go. This is a beautiful, this looks like Bath.
I don't know where it is. I don't think it's Bath. This is by Doug Vogley, who is serving recently as our vice president for the group. And Doug is a very accomplished artist, as you can see. And he donated this for a raffle, which we're going to be raffling this painting off this Saturday at the end of the day, about 4 o'clock. So if anybody wants to come to the show and buy a raffle ticket, you can put your name in the pot to maybe go home with this painting.
All right, and again, if you're watching us on Facebook or TV, you can see this beautiful painting. It looks like it looks like a shot you might see at Cypress Landing or in Bath with all the sailboats docked in the. I got to say, that's probably in Bath right there.
It looks very much like that. I'm not sure.
That's beautiful. And for the folks who didn't see that on the radio, it looks like a picture that you would have taken from the bridge at Bath down onto the docks with all the sailboats, but it's beautiful, beautiful colors. All different kinds of paintings available this weekend?
Yes, we have about 20 artists who are displaying their work. So we will have between 200 and 300 pieces of art. And this includes things like cards and prints and much, much original art. So we have a lot to offer.
Where's it taking place and what time?
It's going to be at the First Christian Church on 14th Street from 10 to 4. And we have
Quail Ridge.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
Right. Right across. And we will have a Meet the Artist hour from 10 to 11. And all the artists should be there that morning. And we'll have refreshments. And it's just a really fun day.
So you can come and see what's available. And then I take it you negotiate the price with the artist, or are the prices marked on it, or
the
what?
Price will be marked on the paintings. Okay. Mm-hmm. We'll have a section for prints and reproductions. And then we'll have a big section for original art.
Right. Okay. And it starts at 10. And how long will it go?
Till 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
All right. 10 o'clock. Or did you say 9 o'clock?
10 o'clock.
10 o'clock till 4 o'clock, First Christian Church, in the Fellowship Hall or someplace
yes.
there? Yeah. Okay, good.
Very, very easy to find. Very easy to just walk in.
So if you've been wanting some original art for your den or your office or your living room or your kitchen...
That
anywhere,
is correct.
Or
that's
your beach
correct.
Place. This would be a great place to pick up some really good original art at a great price, probably.
That's right. And you don't have to buy. You can just come and enjoy the work.
Yeah,
I mean, you know,
yeah.
It's just amazing the talent that we have in Greenville.
Yeah, it is. All right. You'll be there, I guess.
I will. All day.
All the artists, what, 20 artists will be there, something like that?
Okay, good.
It's a really neat group, the Greenville Brushstrokes. These folks do incredible work. It's really great amateurs doing art. I guess you're all amateurs, right?
We are. We are.
But you're selling your art, so I guess that makes you not an amateur anymore.
Yeah, we're the starving artists.
You're the starving artists, the professionals. All right. Well, thank you for that, and I'll mention it again. We get closer to the weekend, and good luck with it.
Thank you, Henry.
Hope you have a big turnout.
Thanks for having us.
Saturday at First Christian Church from 10 to 4. For the annual Greenville Brushstroke Spring Art Show and Sale. All right, 19 in front of 9. McGee has sports coming up next. Some interesting things happening with this new commission being headed up by Condoleezza Rice. They've come out with some new things that college basketball is going to have to live by, and one of them is not going to be good news for people like Rick Pitino. We'll be right back with McGee in sports.
Cellular put towers where most others don't. So people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
If you're a conservative, the choice for Congress is crystal clear. A career Washington lobbyist, Scott Dacey, admits he didn't vote for Donald Trump in the primary. And there's no evidence he ever supported President Trump until Dacey decided to run for Congress. On the other hand, Walter Jones has been called a key ally of President Trump. And conservative leader Mark Meadows says nobody has fought the Washington establishment harder and longer than Walter Jones. Walter Jones, a leader, not a lobbyist.
I'm Walter Jones, and I approve this message.
Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is the truck dealer in Eastern North Carolina. We are overloaded with new Ram trucks, and we've discounted every one of them to move.
It's the spring sales event. Folks from all over Eastern North Carolina are heading to Washington to save on new Ram trucks. Get up to $12,000 in total savings on select Ram 1500 trucks right now.
Visit us at WashingtonChrysler.com. Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Drive a little to save a lot.
The road to success is always under construction. It starts with a foundation established by the men that came before. It takes a first-class facility where pirates can assemble on Saturdays in the fall. And it takes all hands on deck to accomplish greatness through the purchase of ECU football season tickets and membership in the Pirate Club. 2018 is a new opportunity to build, and we're here to create. Join us by visiting ecupirates.com.
We're only human.
We get angry.
Out of control.
Mad to the core.
So cancer, now that you've teed us off.
You got two options.
Get out of the way or get rolled over by our army.
Riley's army.
Get teed off with all of us and join Delcor at the Teed Off with Cancer Dinner and Golf Tournament.
It's all here at the Greenville Country Club, April 25th and 26th. Sponsor, donate, or just get involved. For more information, go to teedoffatcancer.com.
We'll be right back.
The OptiFast program at the Vidant Wellness Center is not your typical weight loss program. OptiFast is a safe, professionally supervised meal replacement program combining comprehensive lifestyle changes along with expert counseling and ongoing personalized support.
At the end of the 12-week program, I was so happy because I met my goal. I lost the 25 pounds that was my target. I dropped 2 pant sizes. It was simple, shakes, bars, and soups. You do that and the weight starts to come off. The product, it tastes good, it fills you up. So I love that I joined, I love that I met my target. This program is a lifestyle change for me.
Talk of the Town on 103.7 WTIV and 94.1 WNBU.
Now, here we go.
Now, here's Henry Hinton.
Front of 9. Welcome back to Talk of the Town. McGee rejoins me here at the desk this morning. We've got sports coming up and some kind of breaking news this morning. There's this commission that's been appointed. Who appointed the commission, by the way, to look into college basketball with all these problems with the FBI and Adidas and Nike and all that?
I think the NCAA Board of Governors and the Board of Directors.
And Condoleezza Rice was put in charge of it.
She's the
former Secretary of State.
She heads it. Yeah,
it's made president of Condoleezza Stanford Rice, University.
Grant Hill,
oh good,
David Robinson, or some names on that committee.
So for so one of the things they're charged with is making some suggestions on how to clean up college basketball. And for years, people have asked, why do people who cheat, college basketball coaches who cheat, they can get their school put on probation and then they can move on to another school.
And it doesn't follow them.
And that the probation and the sanctions don't follow them, but they leave behind that mess at the school that they left. We've seen that over and over again, but this new commission is saying we're going to change that, right? They're suggesting that it be changed.
Yeah, because that coach won't be coaching anymore.
All right, so tell us what they're saying. Here's McGee on sports.
Yeah, this morning the Commission on College Basketball, headed by former Secretary of State Condoleezza Rice, presented its proposed reforms to university presidents of the NCAA Board of Governors and the Division I Board of Directors. Now, some of the, amongst other things, these were three big keys that they commissioned or they brought up this morning, calling for sweeping reforms to minimize one-and-done players, permit players to return to school after going undrafted by the NBA, and ban cheating coaches for life, which is the biggest one.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
That's a good one. If you cheat, you get caught cheating, you can't coach anymore. I like that.
There's also talk about more transparency between the apparel companies that deal with universities, between them, and also a request to have presidents and chancellors conduct reports and submit reports.
Now, you know, with the cheating thing, it's got to be a degree, right? I mean, you can't ban a coach for life for buying a kid a cheeseburger.
Right, yeah.
But, I mean, if somebody's a habitual cheater, like we've seen with, you know, some of these guys, they need to be banned.
Yeah, and again, I don't know what the cheating actually entails, but
what is the one-and-done thing? What are they going to do with that?
Well, they're going to ask the NBA to potentially change their rule and either have – they adopted some a little bit of the Major League Baseball deal. Not the entire thing. You know, Major League Baseball, you can – if you're not drafted out of high school, you have to wait until your third year before you can go to the draft.
Right.
And then you can come back as well for your senior season if you're not – but
– you know what, though? No one's ever challenged that in court. I'm not sure. I'm not – I've always wondered why some great baseball player – and I'm not suggesting that they do, but I've always thought if somebody ever challenged that in court, I don't know that that would stand up. I had that conversation with a college baseball coach recently, actually, and I don't, you know, do you think that would stand up? It would be You know, you know what the argument would be, that the benefit to the kid versus the benefit of the school. Why should
And yeah.
It's all tied up in schools taking advantage of kids and those kind of that argument that players should be paid and all that kind of BS that I don't agree with. But
and keep in mind, all of these proposed reforms have to be approved, so they'll go back to the council, and then once that happens, then legislation has to be adopted to make these proposed reforms formal in college basketball. So it may or may not happen, but I think some will.
Okay. What else is going on? Baseball last night. Pirates did not play at NC State due to weather, and we are being told that NC State is not interested in rescheduling. In fact, they're not even returning calls to the university.
In fact, ECU now had a midweek game this week, and without a midweek game next week, the Pirates are back in action for game one of a three-game set with Houston, who leads Conference USA, the American Athletic Conference this weekend. That game will be on Friday. The ECU Athletics Department on Tuesday, and Adidas, they announced a big new deal in terms of apparel. It's a collaborative creation of a unique brand pattern designed exclusively for ECU. The ECU pattern, inspired by and solely dedicated to the Pirates, joins only a handful of other collegiate athletic programs in the nation to incorporate such a concept into its brand identity. And the Carolina Panthers have exercised the fifth-year option on outside linebacker Shaq Thompson. Thompson is now under contract through 2019. And the NFL draft, the first night or day of the draft, gets underway tomorrow.
By the way, I was talking to somebody in Charlotte who is pretty close to the situation, and we could have a new name the group announced of Carolina Panthers ownership coming up.
Good.
A lot of people have been eliminated at this point, including the local group headed by Felix Sabatis, the Mercedes-Benz dealer in Charlotte. He's out. His group is out. So it looks like it's going to be one of these out-of-town groups. And I asked the question, is there any chance that one of these two remaining groups would want to move the team out of Charlotte? And the answer I got was there's real concern about that, and one group looks like that they definitely would not, and the other group is not saying. So, you know, Jerry Richardson may have some feelings about, you know, who he sells it to as a result of that.
That's a good point.
Although, you know, Jerry spent his whole years threatening to leave Charlotte if he didn't get this and that. But that's what those owners do.
Oh, sure. If they get what they want, they'll stay.
They always do that. All right, 8:52. It is 8 minutes in front of 9 o'clock. Let's get our last break of the morning in, and we'll come back, and we'll have our laugh track for you right after this. Stay with us. More Talk of the Town coming up for Wednesday morning, April 25th. Drive carefully on the way into work this morning.
Let us help you find the right car or truck this spring here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come test drive the all-new redesigned 2018 Jeep Wrangler and take advantage of April lease specials on all-new Jeeps during the spring sales event. Lease a 2018 Wrangler JL for just $209 a month. Lease the new 2019 Jeep Cherokee for only $199 a month. Or lease a new Jeep Grand Cherokee for only $259 a month.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
MTS.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't, so people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
The OptiFast program at the Vidant Wellness Center is not your typical weight loss program. OptiFast is a safe, professionally supervised meal replacement program combining comprehensive lifestyle changes along with expert counseling and ongoing personalized support.
At the end of the 12-week program, I was so happy because I met my goal. I lost the 25 pounds that was my target. I dropped 2 pant sizes. It was simple, shakes, bars, and foods. You do that and the weight starts to come off. The product, it tastes good, it fills you up. So I love that I joined, I love that I met my target. This program is a lifestyle change for me.
The road to success is always under construction. It starts with a foundation established by the men that came before. It takes a first-class facility where pirates can assemble on Saturdays in the fall. And it takes all hands on deck to accomplish greatness through the purchase of ECU football season tickets. And membership in the Pirate Club 2018 is a new opportunity to build. And we're here to create. Join us by visiting ecupirates.com.
Let us help you find the right car or truck this spring here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
See ya. Bye, see ya.
Get up to $12,000 in total savings on select Ram 1500 trucks during the spring sales event. That's up to $12,000 off a new Ram in April. You can't beat this deal on a new truck. Hurry in before they're all gone.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
1079 Just listen to Mark, Mark, and Laura at 710 every morning for details on the birthday game. The game you were born to win. From your friends at
WNCT.
Little grassroots. Very nice, Michael. That because Dylan doesn't know who the grassroots are.
I could have done that.
No, you don't know who the grassroots are.
Who are they?
You'd have put Al Green on there, which would have been fine too.
Who are they?
Grassroots were a great band in the 70s, 60s and 70s, man. Are you kidding? Live for Today, Midnight Confession. Yeah, I could go on and on. Sooner or Later, Love is Going to Get You. 856. Here's an interesting point. The heart surgeon that operated on Bill Clinton will be lecturing to the folks at the East Carolina Brody School of Medicine Heart Institute today. Dr. Joshua Sonnet, who graduated with honors from ECU's medical school in 1988. He's the chief of general thoracic surgery at New York's Presbyterian Hospital at Columbia University Medical Center. In 2005, Dr. Sonnet and his colleagues removed scar tissue that built up in Bill Clinton's chest after a quadruple bypass operation earlier that year. So sounds like Dr. Sonnet had to go in there and fix some problems with Bill Clinton. And most of you didn't think Bill Clinton had a heart. Thank you. I'll be here all week. So that's pretty cool that the heart surgeons will get to hear from this very distinguished heart surgeon that graduated from ECU and operated on Bill Clinton. Who knew? That's kind of cool, isn't it? All right, we're in the studio this morning. We're in the studio tomorrow morning and Friday morning. We're going to be on location at 400 St. Andrews. Again, the candidates for Pitt County Sheriff and the candidates for the Pitt County District Attorney's race. There are primaries in the Democrat and Republican race in both of those offices, sheriff's race and Pitt County DA's race. Want a big crowd out there. Rochelle and Brian Brown will be serving breakfast for free, 7 a.m. We will have the district attorneys in the 7 o'clock hour. We'll start with the Democrat primary for district attorney. And then Republican primary about 7:30 for district attorney, and then the Democrat race for sheriff at 8:05, and the Republican race for sheriff at about 8:30. So come out and be a part of that. All right, let's do our laugh track. Didn't get it in last hour. This is a good one because it has to do with Saturday Night Live. Here's our comedian this morning, John Mulaney, on the Talk of the Town laugh track.
The best intro, by the way, I ever saw of an SNL host with the musical guest was Sir Patrick Stewart, okay? Sir Patrick Stewart was introducing the musical guest, and this is how he did it. He went, "Ladies and gentlemen, salt and pepper!" Like he was surprised by pepper. Like minutes before, they'd been like, "We can't find pepper anywhere." And he was like, "If we must go on with salt alone, we will go on with salt alone." And they're like, 3, 2, 1. And pepper bursts through the door and he's like, "Ladies and gentlemen, salt. And what's this? Pepper!"
I love that. John Mulaney on the laugh track. All right, everybody. Could have a scattered shower later today, but hopefully nothing like yesterday. About a 50% chance of rain. High's going to be about 75. Tomorrow's when the good weather really starts. Sunny and 74 tomorrow. It's going to be sunny Friday and sunny for the weekend. It'll be a great weekend. Temperatures in the mid-70s both Saturday and Sunday. Have a great Wednesday. We'll see you right back here, same bat channel, tomorrow morning.